Can there be a forum or a place where
you can actually... Well, those communities don't often meet, you know, in a sense. And as you pointed out kind of obliquely, is that there's assumptions about the level of use and the level of expertise in communities, which Nikki also knows is often completely skewed. But then assumptions can shift.
Can I just add one thing? Because I know Nikki mentioned it, which was the big city plan, which was a Birmingham experience that's written in Office of Gobbledygook. And then, as a task, got interpreted by a group of people working on the web and produced something that was more readable. What public agencies need to do is, rather than just see that as a threat, actually almost call the bluff of, but all embrace those people who will spend time doing that on some, and then say, well, look, we've got neighbourhood planning, it is written in a way that's a bit impenetrable. How would we go about doing it? And I'm much more proactive in involving those people who are very interested in that sort of stuff, rather than it come in and be seen as a sort of an overt criticism almost, but actually say, well, we know we have to, and explain why some of it has to be written in in the language it might need to be, but actually do it working together rather than, you know, one starting and the other comes
in. That sounds like a strategy that needs to happen right at the formation, because some of our earlier comments were about the disappointment when you come down the process and you get to here, and then you soon realise that what you've been doing isn't actually going to pass the examination process because you're not recognising the constraints that have been set at the wider level. So, strategy for bringing the skills together at the beginning, which can help actually improve communication and dialogue in the face-to-face, but then also actually building teams and resources that can extend that dialogue to online. Anybody else from our table that would want to comment on some ideas?
Maybe just a brief comment. I thought that it would be useful to have a platform that would allow people to upload different kinds of media, so we shouldn't just focus on language, the spoken or written language, but maybe we could also have or give people the possibility to express their feelings and emotions about their neighborhood in pictures, for instance. I think that, you know, because there's only so much you can say in words, or some people can't really, although they speak English, but they're not that literate, if you would like, in their use of language and are not as sophisticated as other people, having got the social and cultural capital for it. Maybe give them different forms of you know, different possibilities to communicate.
There was one other thing which was said on this table, which I noted but almost winced at, I guess, which is there is a desire for a single tool. And I say winced because I don't believe that's ever going to happen. Or someone who called it the God tool or something. but that was a worry about, God, there's so much out there. And, you know, I said, oh, we've probably already got 200 tools. That, you know, we can list, and these are the things that people are saying. And there is an anxiety about that. It's just too much. So one of the things which could be helpful, again, it's a little bit like this forum at the beginning of a process, is actually doing actually dedicated local social media surgeries or maybe it's a program that some of the supporting organizations could consider. So that you can actually break down the barriers behind this plethora of existing tools that are already there, and then you don't have to use any of them.
Yeah, I mean, I was just going to say that what we're in danger is matching the community groups to the social tools. It should absolutely be the other way around. We work with the community and what they feel would be most appropriate, and then you make the tools. I think there is a bit of a danger that it's done the other way around.
Yeah, absolutely. It has to be. The communication tools have to be adopted by the communities, otherwise that's pointless.
And ones that they feel they'd like to have a go at, if it's something that's new, because I think some social media is very exciting and creative, but actually there are some that will want to just use more traditional ways, or participatory appraisal, or whatever it is. Mm. And then we... whoever's facilitating the process needs to be flexible with that, rather than, you know,
get we had some stuff on this table that actually online also creates offline communities. We only ever really use online, if I'm honest, to get offline communities. Mm-hmm. So actually, I think depending on, you know, because if your focus is to get everybody on the web, then so everybody needs to be clear about Do you know what I'm saying about the underpinning reasons for having the online stuff as well? Is it actually to create communities both online and offline, basically?
Yeah, I mean, that's an interesting one because, I mean, my personal view is it's actually for better communication in the offline community. It's, it's about neighbourhood planning. These are real places, real people living locally. In the web, there's talk about hyper-local, which touches that. I mentioned my mother's example in Shropshire. She uses email. Now, okay, it's not web, I mean, but it's still using similar technologies. But it's purely, they've moved from no communication, knocking on doors, to... which is good, that still happens, but they can't get to everyone. They now all mass email everybody in the parish council. Mm. 15 years ago, 18 years ago, no one had email, so it sort of moves to suit the community, their adoption of the technologies at that stage we're at. I think for me it is about, you know, if you don't have good communications, are you sure that you're reaching the whole community, get into hard to reach groups. There's a few comments here about how do we know this is we're being representative? Is 21 people the right number? Is that represent the community? So I think I'm interested in finding out tools and methods which can enable confidence to be in a community because they are using tools which help them be more open and transparent and reach out to the widest possible.
But we did a project recently where we just asked people about their own local heroes. That was it, you know. And as a result, they all made a 3-minute film, all very different. It wasn't kind of like you're getting three pictures and your paragraph dialogue. Each film was different. And each one of those groups, and a lot of them are elderly, but they're going back and they want more digital now. So if you start with that person, I mean, I'm not saying this will work globally for this, but what we realise is if you start with a person and build that relationship and then they start to trust the technology for their needs, then in a sense if you cascade that out as a kind of driver for this, then, but I mean that's time consuming and stuff, but you know.
The key is content though, because you're starting with a great call to action to make some content which they own, and that then drives the interest.
And there's also something about it being you know, it's not agenda driven. It's very personal, but then it's stuff that people want to share. And I think we're looking at how we can now cascade that trust and that kind of get use of the technology, because they're using different stuff now. We've got 79-year-old Irish people using Twitter, which I'm really, really proud of.
I think the ownership thing is really important as well, and not at all talking about the very DIY, you can build your own things with them. So they're very kind of shareable, so blogs or YouTube, whatever, you can kind of build your own thing rather than someone giving you a template which you have to kind of follow religiously. You haven't really got much flexibility with that. So it's kind of giving people tools that they can kind of just twist and turn them how they want, and it's their thing.
I think ownership of data is also fundamental, so I mentioned my mother again. She won't put her face ever on the internet, don't use social media because she thinks, well, and she's right actually, she doesn't own that data which she uploads to a free social network.
But it's ownership as well over the message that's going out around that community. Yeah. You know, they don't know, they want to kind of broadcast themselves.
I should just say it to you that all the existing tools that we've put down today, I am sort of collecting them up, and the ones from last week and later on this week as well, collecting them up and putting them online. I think I've put a lot of them online already on my Delicious page, and also in a kind of non-web 2 word page format that I'll send to you all, so hopefully we can share everything that we have today.
Can we move to the table, the discussion to this table?